Very good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's market commentary. So we shall see Nifty on daily time frame chart. So although Nifty opened gap up today, it was around 0.5% gap up opening, and we can clearly see that the trend line resistance and the horizontal resistance combined is acting as a very strong resistance to Nifty. Now Nifty is very near to our bullish breakout. So once it closes above this 10,855, we can start our bullish trades or bullish bets on Nifty. But on first hand, what we need to clearly see is Nifty is facing a resistance near the trend line resistance. So let us slightly correct this trend line resistance a bit. So we need Nifty sustaining above this trend line resistance and horizontal resistance. So that is the first point of observation. Second, it is trading above central pivot point. So it has already entered into bullish zone. And third, it is already trading above the 20 period moving average. And it also gave a breakout above this short term trend line resistance. So on 4th July and 5th July, we awaited a breakout of this trend line and we awaited price sustaining above this trend line resistance, but we could not get that. And on Friday, that is on 6th July, we had price breaking out of this trend line and it also sustained above that. So that's a good sign of intermediate bullishness in Nifty. But for long-term bullishness, we'll definitely await the level of 10,855 to be taken out. So on daily time frame, these are the major points of discussion. And if we can see RSI also, it is sloping upwards daily. So it is making higher lows. So even if it is a price or even if it is an indicator, once it is making higher lows, so then that is a very strong indication of bullishness coming up. Now we know that RSI is an early indicator of price, so it is a leading indicator. So RSI is signaling a bullishness in price. Now going down to lower time frame, which is hourly time frame. So on hourly time frame, as of now, a bearish divergence is visible, but we never know if it will be taken out today or not. So we'll just draw a line and keep for our safety. So this is price making higher high and RSI making a lower high. So connecting the respective highs of the candles and connecting the respective highs of RSI. So both are not in mutual agreement. So this is a divergence in RSI, bearish divergence. Now we have new pivot points for this week. And as we can see, it did not reach R1 yet. And even before that, price is facing a bearish divergence. So R1 is in confluence with a daily horizontal resistance. So that is a point of confluence of these resistances here. So that is a point to be seen. And next, Bollinger Bands. Even Bollinger Bands also, it is trading above the upper channel of Bollinger Band. So if this becomes a pure RSI bearish divergence and if price comes down, then mean reversion will take place and price will revert back to 20 period moving average. Instead, if this divergence is taken out and if price closes above this R1, then it will continue its bullish journey. Now coming down to 15 minute time frame. So I think even on 15 minute time frame, we have a bearish divergence. So on 60 minute and 15 minute, both are showing bearish divergence here. But yes, once this 10,855 is taken out, even this bearish divergence will also get invalidated. And enabling the pivot points, as you can see, 10,855 is R2 for intraday. So it is R1 on weekly pivot points and R2 on intraday pivot points. So this is a very strong point of confluence, resistance confluence. So we'll be on bullish side only above 10,855. Until then, you just watch the journey, the ups and downs, the gap ups and gap downs. You just watch the journey but we will initiate a trade only above 10,855, because there, as we can see, there are point of confluences of resistances, and price is also making a bearish divergence on hourly time frame as well as 15 minute time frame. So that is not a good sign of bullishness. Now Bollinger Bands also, first candle it traded above the upper channel. Now price can try to come down to 20 period moving average and exhibit a mean reversion. So in order to remove all these confusions, just wait until 10,855 is taken out. Now going to the other index, Bank Nifty. So Bank Nifty, even here also RSI is showing higher momentum. So the slope of RSI is sloping upwards. So that is a sign of bullishness. But even Bank Nifty also, we are very clear that if you had already entered on the breakout of this trendline resistance, then that is okay. You can just continue a trade. But if you want to take a new position, you need to wait until 26,811 is taken out. So no resistances in terms of pivot points in between. Only this Bollinger Bands will act as a resistance when it comes to 26,800. So it will be a good idea to wait until that price is taken out. On hourly time frame, so Bank Nifty is sloping upwards. This bearish divergence may not hold long actually, because the momentum with which Bank Nifty is going up is very strong. So in this situation, if RSI reaches its prior high, that will signal continuation of momentum. That we cannot term it as a bearish divergence, like price going up and RSI reaching its prior high. That property actually we call it as continuation in momentum. So that is clearly visible in Bank Nifty now. Once this 26,800 is taken out, a clear bullishness will be seen in Bank Nifty. So on hourly time frame, now we need to enable the pivot points and see. So in between that, we have R1 as our first resistance. So if this is taken out, even R1 will also be taken out in turn. So that's no need of any tension for that. So even Bollinger Bands also. So a very clear decision here. Just wait until 26,811 is taken out. On 15 minute also we have a bearish divergence. And if we enable the pivot points, it is in between R1 and R2. So this is the high, prior high made by RSI. So by the time it comes to 76, it will reach this 26,800. So on all time frames, even Nifty or in Bank Nifty, we have only a single price level. In Nifty, it is 10,855, and in Bank Nifty, it is 26,811. Once this price is taken out, both the indices will definitely exhibit a further upward movement. Now we shall go to our individual stocks. So first is HCL Tech. So HCL Tech, we had a cup and handle pattern here, and today the cup and handle is giving a breakout. By the end of the day, if it sustains above this neckline, then the next target for HCL Tech would be 997. And if you see, this month's R2 is exactly at 997. So that should be your final target for this month. And it is also trading above the 20 period moving average. Not only that, it is giving a close above the upper Bollinger Band. So we can expect a channel expansion happening in HCL Technologies. So this was the first stock, and the next one is Yes Bank. On hourly time frame, we could see a very clear flag breakout today, that too with a gap up opening. So flag is breaked and prior swing high is also breaking in Yes Bank. Now we need price sustaining above this prior swing high on hourly time frame. So if prior sustains there, then we can keep this zone prior to swing highs we have. So this zone we can keep as our next level of target. So let the price sustain here. Now we shall see if we have any pivot points in between. So we have R1 in between. So square off half of the position here and then trail until this zone is met. So strong bullishness can be seen here. Now we need to see if we have any bearish divergence. Yes, we have a bearish divergence. But the momentum with which RSI is going up, that is telling that price can reach there. And going down to intraday time frame, which is 15 minute. But in 15 minute, the point of concern would be the range between open and close of all these candles. Very short range actually, so less than 0.5%, which tells that there is a loss of momentum in its upward journey. Now we need one big green candle in the middle of this journey so that we can confirm that price is going to go up, because even on 15 minute time frame we have a bearish divergence. Price is going up and RSI is trading lower, and even candles are also showing a lower momentum. So we want one big green candle which can take out today's high. Once that happens, definitely Yes Bank will continue its momentum until 367 is reached. But until then, you need to be cautious, because there is a bearish divergence on 60 minute time frame and 15 minute time frame. At the same time, candles are not showing strong momentum. So here the conclusion would be on Yes Bank, at least in 15 minute time frame, we want a big green candle which can take out today's high. So it should take out in first instance itself. So one big green candle, the first instance of one big green candle should take out today's high. So this is Yes Bank, and then we have Axis Bank also. There's a breakout of triangle pattern in Axis Bank. See, and even it already reached the target too. So above this triangle from 515, our target was 528. So around 3% was my target, and it already gave in intraday itself. So there's no point in discussing it anymore. Let's see other stocks which people are asking. So first is TCS. So above this triangle and above the prior resistance, TCS went until R1. So profit booking can be seen in TCS now. It might be a short-term profit booking in TCS. So there's nothing much to worry about this. But this week, it is trying to close below the central pivot point. We'll try to keep a stop loss for this. So S1 is where you need to exit, 1862. So that is a prior swing high, and that is also this week's S1. So if price reaches here, then you need to exit TCS. Otherwise, you can just continue your bullish position in TCS. Z Entertainment Limited. Yeah, this pattern is already drawn and we are waiting a breakout of this trend line resistance. Above the trend line resistance and above central pivot point, you can be on bullish side. And we have results on 17th July. So we can definitely have a breakout of this 550 level. So Reliance, it is already in the middle of journey. We are seeing it in every market commentary. So just note down these levels. Until the trend line resistance is not broken, do not initiate any trade. We have trend line resistance and we have trend line support, two trend line supports. So below central pivot point, be on bearish side, and above the trend line resistance, be on bullish side. M&M also, we have a breakout. If price sustains above this trend line resistance today, R2 will be our next target, and then we'll just keep on trailing until the swing lows are made. So as and when the swing lows are made, we'll just move our stop loss to those particular swing lows. Even IndusInd Bank is trying to approach its breakout level, but it is facing a stiff resistance around here. So it is bullish only above 1995, and the first level of target can be 2022. Or you can just trail it until this R2 is met. So this 2022 was prior month's R1, or you can just shift it towards R2, but wait until this price is taken out. 1995, the prior swing high. Indiabulls Housing Finance. So took a support near trend line support as well as the horizontal support. Now we need a breakout of this prior resistance level, or you can just enter the bullish trade above the central pivot point, because above this resistance we have one more resistance at 1230. So if you want to trade it for intraday, then that is okay. Just enter above 1210, and on the same day if it reaches 1235, then you can exit, because that is R1 of that month and prior swing high. So you can exit there. Or otherwise, if you want to hold it for long, just enter above central pivot point. Keep this low as your stop loss, 1107, I think. Yeah, 1107 should be your stop loss. Central pivot point, if price sustains above that, that should be your entry point. R1 as your first target and R2 as your second target. This is for IBUL Housing Finance. Tata Steel. Yeah, even in Tata Steel also, a long-term trend line resistance is there. Even in this, we are awaiting a breakout of trend line resistance as well as the central pivot point. So if it sustains above the central pivot point, just keep R1 as your first target, because there is a prior swing high and R1. Both of these in confluence will definitely act as a strong resistance. So that should be your first target. And above this, straight away the prior swing high. Prior swing high to R2 should be your next level of target. Tech Mahindra, trading at a very strong support zone. Now, in our prior market commentaries, we drew this triangle pattern, and once the first 1 hour candle on 5th July, when it gave a break below this, price reached its prior support, and now it is taking a very strong support there and bouncing back. So on daily time frame, if we see, we'll be bearish on Tech Mahindra only below these support levels, and the prior strong support zone should be your target here. And if you want to be bullish, what you can do is wait until the central pivot point is taken out and then keep 722 as your next level of target. So Hero MotoCorp, not a good price level to enter as of now. For to be on bullish side again, wait until 3713 is taken out, because it is already in the middle of journey. So if you are a breakout trader, this is your perfect level to enter. If you are a reversal trader, this was the actual journey when price took a clear support at prior month's S1. Is Colgate Palmolive. Even here it is in the middle of journey. The best price to enter into Colgate Palmolive would be to wait until 1083 is reached, because that is S2 of this month and it is also prior swing low. Because since it is in the middle of journey, this is not a correct point to enter. But what can happen as of now is, this was the prior resistance occurred here for the first time, second time, and when this green candle took out that resistance, it will now act as a support. So even if now, if it takes a U-turn from here, you need to search for a bullish opportunity. So pivot points won't help you because it did not reach S1 as of now. So only Bollinger Band's 20 period moving average can give you a clear indication. So even it is also far away. So only central pivot point of the month can give you a clear indication. Or on early time frame, do we have any pivot points? So here, this is a bullish divergence, first confirmation of bullishness on early time frame, and we also have the central pivot point, which is nothing but today's high. So I think for short term, if you want to trade, if it closes above central pivot point, you can be on bullish side, keeping 1185 as your target. So Colgate Palmolive, you can enter in shorter time frame, that is on 60 minute time frame. Let it close above central pivot point, and then you can enter on bullish side, keeping R1 as your first target, 1174, and 1185 as your next level of target. This is all because it exhibited a bullish divergence near the support zone. And if you see, there is also 20 period moving average near the central pivot point itself. So once that is taken out, as per both the indicators, it will be entering into bullish zone. Now let's take the other stock, SR Transfin. We saw a very big downfall in SR Transfin in past trading days. We just need to make sure, did it take a support near long-term support or not? And yes, it took a support near the long-term support zone. So this is the long-term support zone, a prior gap up level, and many candles took support near this price zone. So it took support here, but now we need to wait for a U-turn in price level. So, and if you see, it is trading near S2. Now, when should you start your trade in this particular trade? Once the open equal to high of 4th July is taken out. So the price level is 1224.05. Only above this, you need to enter. So that's it for today. Thank you all for joining Market Commentary.